was telling you about fashion statement. Here you go. The hairstyle.
I just love it. So you have to tell me who did it first of all. Who was your inspiration? How did you come up with the idea?
Okay, I did the twist in Nigeria when I went to Beijing.
Okay.
I did it for $20.
See, we have to go back to Africa because here we're struggling. You want to do your hair here in New York City? It's going to be like between $150 and
$200. Yeah.
This is too much.
And then my friend styled it for me, Caroline Reserve. She styled it, and then my friend, you know, she helped me fix it, and that's Nara. And yeah, that's it for my hair.
Cameraman, can you just zoom on the hairstyle? You know, we don't want to know the entire secret, but just for the viewers have an idea of the, you know, the fashion twist in the hairstyle. And how did you come up with the dress?
Okay, so I ordered the dress and then I got my time, so my tailor, inspiration, he had sewn me something in like one day and I designed it, and I actually have a fashion that we call Inspired Envy.
Okay.
And how this came about, put some poop roaches over here you know,
to keep it glamour.
That thing was out there, so I had to put that in, and shoes by Gucci.
Okay.
Aldo and
oh, you fancy, huh?
Nice. So, can you tell us more about this fashion line?
Yeah, it's up and coming. It's called Inspired Envy, and it's Inspired Envy in a good way because when you walk, you walk into envy. It's like, dang, I love what she got on, you know. Mm-hmm. But also, the type of person I am, I like to show skin, and you know, you
which
have
is nothing
to.
Wrong. There's nothing wrong with that, but you have to do it in a good way.
Yeah.
Yes.
So whoever wears it, you have to be confident whenever you wear Inspired Envy because a lot of people are going to be envious.
Oh, of course. Yeah, and it's about, I think it's all about your identity and what you're trying to convey as an individual. You are talking about, you know, fashion designers. What kind of designer can I find in your closet?
Gucci. I love Gucci.
Mm-hmm.
And also Versace.
Yeah.
And really, I love Aldo.
Like, although you know what, you're right.
I love
it. It's simple.
Very simple, and they don't advertise the label. That's one thing I love about it.
Mm-hmm.
And and Giuseppe. You know, I just bought two pairs and I love it.
Okay, your shoes freak.
Yes,
I'm the guilty. Me too. It's too much. And do you have any African designers that you support?
It's on Instagram. They do the kente prints.
Yeah.
I don't remember their names, but I love their outfits. Like, it is.
Now, since the start of the show today, I've been talking so much about African music, African culture, and most importantly, fashion, African fashion and fashion in general. And right now, seated next to me is a tastemaker, somebody who's got his ear to the streets, his finger to the pulse. By the looks of things itself, it's clear to see what this man does. I'm sitting next to Swanky Jerry. How are you doing tonight, sir?
I'm great. I'm doing great. Thank you.
I'm very happy. When I saw you walking on the red carpet, I was like, okay, the fashion man is here. Talk to me some more about what it's like to be a designer, a stylist, a personal shopper, kind of all under one roof. What is that like? Is it a competitive industry back home, or is it something that you've obviously branded yourself, but was it a competitive industry before you've made that name for yourself?
Yeah, everything has always been a competitive industry in fashion, in music, in the movie industry. So it was not an easy task, but God willing, you know, the craft just speaks for itself. And and you know, everything works like with time, and you just have to keep working. That's what happened. I just kept on working. I believed in myself. A lot of close people actually believed in me, so that gave me a push. So
now, talk to me about your style, because you're very versatile. Sometimes I see you and you look like the most dapper man ever. Sometimes you got this little urban look to you. So when do you pick and choose what you're feeling like, and how do you choose what your artists or your clients are going to wear?
Personally, my style is very crazy because you can't really predict. Yeah, I could have come here in my pajamas if I wanted or if I felt like that.
It's still going to sound
So, but most times I dress with the occasion because first and foremost, you can be out of place. And secondly, you know, you have to look right for the occasion. So I dress up properly for every occasion. If I have to go to the beach, I dress up a certain way. If I'm just chilling, I dress up a certain way. Even though I'm working today, but after work, I had to go 0 to 100. Yeah.
Now, I know I want to pick your brain. You've worked with some of my favorite industry people, but one of my favorites, Tonto, is one of my favorites. Oh. Before even the music, because of her acting.
Yeah.
And I know you're a close friend of hers. You also style a lot of her stuff. Mm-hmm. And I know she's just did the introduction and she's now moving on to this, you know, next chapter in her life.
What?
Can you please, I know you're going to be hands-on when it comes to all of the stuff that's happening. Can you give us some tidbits? Is she wearing Vera Wang? What you picking? What are you choosing? What are the color schemes? Can you give us anything? I know Tonto's gonna kill you.
I wish I could, but you know what's happening? Mm-hmm. It's like Swanky Jerry is involved, do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
Like I am the man for that goal. Do you understand? Poco has no worries absolutely. And
will you be styling Mr. X as well?
Yeah, both of them. Both of them. I'll be styling both of them. And the big surprise is going to be disastrous, you know. It's going to be epic in the entertainment industry because it's something that's never, ever happened. And it's going to happen on that day.
Like you told me earlier, your style of dressing, you know, you can call it crazy, but it's very unique.
Yeah.
Are there any people who have inspired you to maybe think outside the box, to maybe be more fearless in your dressing?
I'm a very, 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 very creative mind.
Mm-hmm.
I have countless people that inspire me every day with the different styles. Like, it's not something that I just look at one person or just pick up one person and just follow up the person. No, I'm very urban, so I work with what's on. You get what I say?
What is your favorite fashion trend right now? What do you see that, like, you know what, this I could sport, I could rock this look?
I always rock denim. I love denim. Mm-hmm. Denim is like ageless. It's forever. It's come to stay. It's not going. I definitely would do denim any day for any occasion.
Did you see, guys, how, you know, so you see the dress is beige and black, and the handbag is black and beige. You see? It's black and beige. It's all about detail. Gentlemen, I must tell you, whenever I see this guy, DJ Freshy Gang, he's always in suit and tie. He looks like a dandy, like, you know, the UDR's radio, James Bond. Amen.
Amen.
Cameraman, zoom the hat. Yeah, strike the pose.
Please, if I can be
safe. Oh, yes. Oh, I'm in love with you.
Man, you're looking beautiful. Look, zoom right here, too. Can you see her outfit is so African and so beautiful? See that?
Yeah, I'm not being fair. No. Purple rain. Yes! He went for the purple!
Right now you cannot see the gorgeousness that's going around surrounding me, but I'm trying my best to pull some spectacular people out of the way and onto the red carpet. Right now I'm sitting next to African Join, a beautiful NYC-based model, is that correct?
Yes,
it is. Are you excited about being here tonight?
I'm like really excited. Like, I've been waiting all year for this.
No. And there's so many people on the roster who's going to be here tonight. We got Yemi Alade, we got Davido, we got Ice Prince. Who are you excited to see?
Yemi Alade, Ice Prince. Just a couple of people. Like, I'm actually like really excited, so I don't even know. I just want to see everybody, like everybody.
That's the energy that's in here tonight. People are starting to gather slowly. There's celebs starting to trickle in. But before we get out of here, before I kick her off the red carpet and into the staging area, tell me really fast, what you listening to? If I were to snatch your iPod, if I were to jump in your car right now, what kind of Afrobeat songs will you be playing?
You listen to one, first of all, Dorobuchi.
That's gotta be on repeat still.
Yeah, two, Yemi Alade. Johnny still is like, it's still there.
On
it's
rotation.
Still there.
Still on rotation.
I basically have everything. Like, I can't even name it because I really love African songs. Mm-hmm. Like, that's all I listen to.
Now, before we get here, I want you to just do a twirl because you look phenomenal. You look fantastic. You look gorgeous. I love the gown. She's looking like an Afrocentric goddess right now. Please make sure you guys stay connected on Facebook, Twitter. Where else can we find you?
Instagram. Everything is African John.
Spell that for us.
African, AfricanJawn.
African John's on the red carpet with us tonight. Thank you so much.
Anything else?
Talk to me about your sense of style. You're so ladylike. I'm actually one of your followers, so I do know that you're a very beautiful fashionista. Talk to me about your style.
I just like to be very comfortable and very easygoing, simple, classy. I don't like too much stuff. I don't know if you notice, I don't wear a lot of jeans or pants. I like dresses and skirts, and that's just my style. Comfortable stuff.
Well, like I said, this is the 10th annual NEA Awards. Are you excited about being here today?
Yes, I think this is my fourth one, actually. No. I didn't come last year, but this is my fourth one. So I'm very proud of them. They're doing a good job.
Now, this year we have Ice Prince as a host and Olsos as a host. Are you excited to see them?
Yes, definitely excited to see Ice Prince. I'm a big, 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 big fan. I'm excited to see Olsos as well. I just attended her wedding a couple of weeks ago, so I'm happy to see her here too.
Now, this is an explosion of fashion, beauty, culture, talent, all of those good things under one roof. Thank you so much for joining me here on the red carpet. But before you leave, I want to make sure that all of these people know how to stay connected with you, how to keep in touch with you. So how do we do that?
Fumi New York on Instagram.
You guys heard it here first. Fumi New York on Instagram. We're having a wonderful time. This is the 10th annual NEA Awards. I want to head on inside and enjoy the show.
Thank you
so much.
Nice meeting you.
Thank you. You as well. Thank you.